Hi everyone, welcome to this third video in my series about Ramanujan. Now last time I did promise you that this video would be a little bit controversial. Some of you may have even guessed what I'm going to talk about today. It's a result that Ramanujan first discovered while still in India before he came to Cambridge, but only something that he perfected with the help of G.H. Hardy. It's a result about the sum of all integers. So it's 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, going on forever. Now, common sense tells us that this is going to go off to infinity. But Ramanujan had a different answer, and his answer does make sense from the correct point of view. But you're not going to like it. Ramanujan's answer for the sum of all integers was minus 1/12. Which is crazy, right? It sounds crazy, right? If you don't like it, I don't blame you if you don't like it. Even Ramanujan thought it was crazy. He wrote letters to G.H. Hardy sending him this result, but saying, well, please don't send me to the lunatic asylum. So this does sound crazy, especially if you compare it with the classic formula of adding up integers 1 to n. So this is a finite sum where you've got 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to n. This is called a triangle number. If you can imagine having a row of 1, a row of 2, a row of 3, a row of 4, it'd make a triangle shape. Now, there is a formula for working out a triangle number. If you consider taking the first number and adding it to the last number, you get n plus 1. If you take the second number and add it to the second to last number, you get n plus 1 again. In fact, if you keep adding up in pairs in that way, each pair is n plus 1. And how many pairs do we have? Well, we've got n over 2 pairs. So altogether, the sum is n over 2 lots of n plus 1. And you get this formula for triangle numbers. And you can see that the triangle numbers are getting bigger and bigger and bigger. What Ramanujan was doing was essentially considering the infinite triangle number, and he was getting this strange answer, minus 1/12. The thing is, Ramanujan hadn't been the first mathematician to notice that answer. Other mathematicians had seen it as well. Euler had seen that answer. Riemann had seen that answer. What was new was Ramanujan's method for getting that answer. And that's what I want to explain in this video. And I'm hoping that by explaining it, you'll have a better appreciation of where that answer comes from. But I'll tell you right now and up front what I want you to take away from this video. So what Ramanujan had done, his method could be applied to traditional sums. And if you apply it to traditional sums, you would get the answer you expect. But then if you apply Ramanujan's method to, say, the sum of all integers, then you get this minus 1/12. So what Ramanujan had done is he had generalized the idea of a sum. Ramanujan's method was based on estimating the area under a curve. So you can estimate the area under a curve by using rectangles. Each rectangle has a width of just 1 unit, and the height of the rectangle is given by the value of the function at integers. So the total area of those rectangles is just the sum of the function at integers up to some integer n. Now there's going to be a difference between that value and the true area under the curve, but there is a formula for that difference. It's called the Euler-Maclaurin formula, and it tells us that the difference between the sum and the integral is given by repeatedly differentiating the function and then evaluating that at n minus evaluating that at 0. Now these terms labelled B are called Bernoulli numbers. The sequence for Bernoulli numbers looks like this. And then at the very end we have this small remainder term, and that is small enough that we can ignore it. If you take all the terms that don't depend on n, you get something that Ramanujan called the constant of the function. So this is a constant. This will always stay the same in that Euler-Maclaurin formula as n tends off to infinity. Edward Frenkel on Numberphile gave this a lovely description. He described this constant as being like a golden nugget surrounded by infinity. Now, G.H. Hardy pointed out to Ramanujan that if you want to use this method to find sums, then when that function f is a convergent function, then this should equal the traditional sum. So Hardy modified the idea and he gave this as the constant instead. So this is still a constant, but it does depend on your choice of a, and a is usually 0 or infinity. If f is convergent, then you would use infinity. And in that Euler-Maclaurin formula, a lot of terms actually disappear. Because f is convergent, it's tending to zero. So a lot of terms disappear, and you'll find that that modified constant is equal to the traditional sum. If f was divergent, then that wouldn't be defined. So instead, we would evaluate the constant at zero. And in that case, you would get Ramanujan's constant. So let's do it. Let's find the constant for the sum of 1 to infinity. In that case, the function is just x, and if we apply Ramanujan's constant to that, you will get the same answer that he did. You will find that it is equal to minus 1/12. Now, this isn't the only method that comes up with that answer, the minus 1/12 answer. For example, you can use the Riemann zeta function, and that will also give you minus 1/12. So this isn't just nonsense. And today, scientists use this in high-level physics. Apparently, they use it in string theory. But don't ask me about that. It sounds hard. If you're still not happy, then think about it some more. But if it helps, let me say this. Maths is about solving problems through abstraction. Like those triangle numbers we looked at earlier, those are finite sums, but we can work those out instantly because we had a formula for working out triangle numbers. So what we did there is turn that problem into a more abstract problem. Well, if we take that one step further, we can work out infinite sums as well. So convergent infinite sums are those where you're getting closer and closer to a value. And so we take that value to be the sum of the series. And they act a lot like finite sums. You can add them and multiply them like you can with finite sums. And you might feel comfortable with those kind of sums already. Maybe you've seen them before, maybe at school. So you're feeling okay with those. But they do come with their own infinite weirdness themselves. For example, in a previous video, we looked at Leibniz's pi formula. And what you've got there is you're adding up rational numbers. If you add up two rational numbers, you get a rational number. So if we keep adding up rational numbers, then we should get a rational number. But with this formula, we get pi over here. We get an irrational number, which is really strange. It turns out that if you consider the sequence of partial sums, then the final answer does not have to be a member of that sequence. So infinite weirdness exists already. If we just take this one step further, one step more abstract, then we can work out values for all kinds of infinite sums, even those that aren't getting closer and closer to a value. But the important thing is any method we have has to be able to be applied downwards. So we have to be able to apply that method to, say, convergent sums and still get the expected answer. You just have to embrace the infinite weirdness. This was my third video about Ramanujan, inspired by the release of the new film, The Man Who Knew Infinity, all about the life of Ramanujan. I might come back with another video about the film itself, but until then, if you have been, thanks for watching.